Hi folks, I hope you enjoy all these videos. Please do not forget to subscribe. Please also share these videos amongst your friends and colleagues. Please do like them. Thank you.
In this slide, we will talk about CDMA 2000 RAN architecture. Look at the figure that's appearing on your screen. The first element is of course the mobile station, that is a subscriber's handset. Functions as a mobile IP client, interacts with the access network to obtain appropriate radio resources for the exchange of packets, keeps track of the status of the radio resources, accepts buffer packets from the mobile host when radio resources are not in place or radio resources are not sufficient to support the flow of the network. Upon power up, the mobile station automatically registers with the HLR in order to authenticate the mobile, to provide HLR with the mobile's current location, provide the surveying MSC with the mobile's permitted feature set, etc. After successfully registering with the HLR, the mobile is ready to place voice and data calls. These may take either of the two forms, circuit switch data or packet switch data, depending on the mobile's own compliance with the IS 2000 standard. What is IST 2000? IST 2000 defines protocols for several critical CDMA interfaces pertaining to packet transmission, namely A1, A7, A9 and A11 interfaces. Look at the new figure that's appearing on your screen. This is Radio Access Network, RAN. RAN is a mobile subscriber's entry point for communicating either data or voice content. A mobile station accesses the CDMA 2000 network through the RAN. RAN consists of the air link, the cell site tower antenna, BTSS, BSC, packet control function, and communication path between BTS and BSC. The communication path between BTS and BSC is called ABS interface. From the cell site tower to the base station, the interface is called UM. What are the responsibilities of RAN? The RAN maps the mobile to a unique link layer identifier so that the mobile can communicate with the PDSN, which is the data world, authenticates and authorizes the mobile for access service. RAN maintains the established transmission links and later on releases the connections. It manages the radio resources. BTS connects to BSE through PCM T1, E1 and ABIS protocols. While the ABIS interface is standardized and is based on HDLC, that is a high level data link control, the implementation is proprietary and it may vary from vendor to vendor. BSC routes packet data and circuit data between the cell sites and the MSC. BSC is also responsible for mobility management. What is mobility management? We'll see it subsequently. BSC connects to MTX using T1 E1 lines or T1 lines and sends control messages to PDSN using Ethernet protocols. PCF routes IP data packets between MS and PDSN. So these are the responsibilities of RAN. This is nothing but the combined responsibilities of base station, BSC and PCF and a little bit of PDSN. So let's look at BTS, base station transceiver subsystem. This controls the activities of the airlink, acts as the interface between the network and the mobiles, manages RF resources such as frequency assignments, sector separation and transmit power control, manages the backhaul traffic from the cell site to the BSEs to minimize any delays between these two elements. BTS connects to BSC through T1 E1 facilities or direct cables. The ABIS protocol used within this facility are proprietary and are based on HDLC. We have seen that already. Role of various blocks shown in the block diagram will be discussed in our advanced programs and is beyond the scope of this presentation. Let's look at the new figure that's appearing on your screen. This will deal with BSC, base station controller. What's the role of base station controller? This routes voice and circuit switch data between BTS and MSC, provides stable and reliable radio link provision, that is, this takes care of radio resource management, does all connections and disconnections of calls. BSC bears responsibility for mobility management, BSC controls and directs handoffs from one cell site to another. BSC connects to MSC using T1 lines for voice and circuit switch data, connects to unchannelized T1 lines for signaling and control messages to the PDSN using 10BASE-T Ethernet protocol, and the role of various blocks shown in this block diagram will be discussed in our advanced programs and is beyond the current scope of this presentation. Let us look at the packet control network functions of CDMA 2000 now. Look at the figure that's appearing on your screen. So what does the packet control network consist of? It consists of a PDSN to start with. The PDSN is a gateway from the RAN to the public packet network such as internet, ATM, VoIP, etc. and or private packet networks which could be LAN, WAN, VPN of a particular corporate, etc. In a simple IP network, the PDSN acts as a standalone network access server, while in a mobile IP network, it can be configured as either a home agent or as a foreign agent. We'll see all these things in detail. The PDSN does these following activities. This establishes, maintains and terminates point-to-point protocol sessions with the mobile, routes packets between the mobile and the external packet data networks. Data from the mobile is encapsulated in generic routing encapsulations and tunneled from the PCF within the BSC to the PDSN, where it is decapsulated and further processed. The PDSN is the mobility anchor point between the mobile terminal and the packet control network. What is tunneling? We mentioned a term called tunneling. What is tunneling? The PDSN is a gateway from the RAN into public or private data networks. We have seen this. PDSN implements the switching of packet data services of the mobiles. One PDSN, in fact, can be connected to multiple PCFs. It provides the interface between the radio network and the packet data networks. PDSN manages the radio packet interface between the BSS and the IP network by establishing, maintaining and terminating link layer to the mobiles. PDSN authenticates users locally or forwards authentication requests to AAA server, provides an IP address either from an internal pool or through a DHCP server or through an AAA server. PDSN actively manages subscriber services based on the profile information received from the SCS server of the AAA server, performs packet routing to external packet data networks or packet routing to the home agent, which optionally can be via secure tunnels. PDSN terminates the point-to-point protocol sessions initiated by the subscribers. PDSN collects and forwards packet billing data. PDSN can act either as a standalone network access server, a home agent or a foreign agent. These are the functions of PDSN. What is tunneling? It's left to the reader to figure this out now. The next element is packet control function, PCF. PCF is the one which implements the R to P conversion, that is radio to packet connection management. This is the first time where the radio signals are converted into packet signals. Routes IP packet data between the mobile within the cell sites and the packet data serving node, that is it acts as an interface between the RAN and the PDSN. During packet data sessions, PCF assigns available supplemental channels as needed to comply with the services requested by the mobile and paid for by the users. If a particular mobile subscriber has subscribed for higher bandwidth, the PCF will allot more number of supplemental channels in order to meet the subscribed bit rates. PCF maintains consistent link for packets between the radio network and the mobile station. Because of the shortage of radio resources, some radio channels should be released when subscribers do not send or receive data, but the PPP, the point-to-point protocol connection, is to be maintained continuously. In other words, if the subscriber is not sending data, there is no point in holding the radio resources, which can be released for other subscribers, whereas the connection or the session should not be broken. Therefore, the PPP connection has to be intact, whereas radio resources can be released. PCF also ensures buffering of packets when either the radio resources are not sufficient or the data rates are not supported by the PDSN's flow. PCF relays packets between the mobile and the PDSN. These are some of the functions of the network element PCF. Now what is AAA server, AAA server? AAA stands for Authentication, Authorization and Accounting. This AAA server authenticates and authorizes users for network access. It stores subscriber usage statistics for billing and invoicing. The AAA is based on what is called RADIUS, Remote Authorization Dial-In Service. This is analogous to the HLR in the voice networks. What's the next one? Next one is home agent and foreign agent. Foreign agent is a critical entity in the PCN which makes mobility services available in the network. It takes care of the mobility management of the mobiles. The agent locates at the place where mobile node opens its account, receives the registration information from the mobile network. It is one endpoint of home agent, foreign agent tunnel that is created when a mobile network successfully registers with its home agent for mobile IP services. It's a tunnel that is created between HA and FA for the mobile to communicate to the internet world. The other end of the tunnel is the home agent, and the home agent is responsible for attracting traffic destined for the mobile network and tunneling it to the destination mobile of the mobile network. HA-FA sets up the tunnel between FA and HA, transfers data from other computer to the mobile network via the tunnel, supports seamless data roaming into the other networks that support 1xRTT, provides an anchor IP address for the mobile and forwards any mobile bound traffic to the appropriate network for delivery to the handset. Since mobility management is the function of FAHA, it keeps track of the IP address of the mobile wherever it is. It maintains user registration, redirects packets to the PDSN and optionally also tunnels securely to the PDSN. Supports dynamic assignment of users from the AAA and assigns dynamic home addresses. AAA is similar to HLR in the mobile network. In our data communications e-learning series, which the reader must have already gone through, we have extensively dealt with packet switching, packet routing, layer protocols, etc. And hopefully the reader would have already gone through these courses, and therefore we are not dealing on the packet switching functions in this particular presentation. Please look at the figure which deals with core networks. The core network of CDMA 2000 is exactly similar to IS-95 architecture and therefore will not be discussed further in this particular slide.
Hi guys, hope you have enjoyed this video. Before you leave this, please ensure that you are subscribing to this. Also, please do like these videos and share it amongst your friends and colleagues. There are plenty of other videos and I hope you will be able to find time to browse through all these things. Thank you.